Gardner clearly expanded the scope of intelligence to include many cognitive and behavioral abilities. But with the added domains means that there isn't a high correlation between each area of intelligence. So you could be really high in one area of intelligence, but not so high in another. Greg, do you have anything to add about Gardner's theory of intelligence?
Yeah, Gardner's theory has been very appealing to both educators and psychologists in the United States and in Europe. But what they've had to do is develop whole curricula and schools around multiple intelligences.
That's interesting. So it's obviously pretty hard to test this type of intelligence because there's not a simple pen and paper test like there are for the traditional IQ tests.
That's right. In fact, Gardner acknowledges that. He knows that there's no way of simply taking a pen and paper test to test for interpersonal intelligence, for instance. So what educators have to do in these schools is they have to have projects and activities, creative activities, interpersonal tasks that they evaluate.
Okay, so let me ask you this. Now, how do you think you are intelligent?
Well, I would say I'm pretty high on verbal and interpersonal intelligence, not so high on musical intelligence.
So let me ask you this. How are you intelligent?